Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.
Hi, I'm Cherry Johnson with Watauga County Arts Council. You know, the Arts Council does a lot of programs in a lot of places, and one of the programs that you might not have heard a whole lot about is called our Arts Placement Program. Back around 1993, there was a sculptor in town named Jerry Clemens, and I met Jerry at a business after hours with the Boone Area Chamber of Commerce, and Jerry was all excited. He had this incredible idea. He wanted to place art out in area restaurants and hotels and in places, and he wanted local artwork to be available for purchase in these places. So Jerry and I sort of got on board, and we started working on this program, and we started it out at Red Onion Cafe. It eventually grew into several other very well-known venues around this community, and in the years that happened, a lot of, not only did the artists have an opportunity to showcase their artwork, but also, to be honest with you, what I consider the success of the program is not that we continue to do it in every place in town. We can't do that. We don't have that many people. But that we change the expectation of this community. So it's no longer okay to put up copies of work that aren't really original and that aren't really unique and aren't special. People expect to have quality local art. And the Arts Placement Program, to be honest with you, is how that all happened. And so it's due to the success, we owe our success to great artists in our community. We are so rich with artists in our community. And I have one of these artists with me today that I'd like to introduce to you. This is Shirley Hampton. And Shirley is an artist that we've worked with for a long time, many years.
Yes.
And Shirley does a rather unique style of painting that, to be truthful with you, not every style of painting fits in every venue. So Shirley's work is rather unique. So it works in certain places and other places it doesn't work. And that's okay. That's what it's supposed to be.
Right.
And so Shirley's work is not your traditional landscape with mountains and trees and barns. You know, Shirley's work is a little bit unique. It is also not, I've introduced you before to Kent Paulette Durfla, who does basically what he calls the ninja splat, you know, and all kinds of things. Shirley's is in between. She's not one extreme or the other. Your work is kind of graphic, very bright.
Yes.
It's impressionistic as a general rule. Mm-hmm. Your work normally, if it's just what Shirley wants to create.
Exactly.
Has a very colorful, graphic, bold appearance to it.
Right.
Which is really kind of, and you like figures especially,
You
know. Now, that kind of goes back to your roots. Let's talk about who Shirley is, okay?
Okay.
Now, you, I know that you've had several things going on in your life over the years, but one of the things is you were a hairdresser for many years.
Yes.
And we were just talking a few minutes ago about how that's kind of in its own art form. You used hair as your medium.
Yes.
And so you enjoyed creating really cool things. Tell me about some of that.
That was me. I did not like doing somebody's hair and continuously doing the same look.
Uh-huh.
I told them from the beginning, expect some new things because they're cutting and restyling and making it updated.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I found that to be the best part of my hairdressing was cutting, which changed the total look of a person.
Right.
And a hair color. So those were my really my two things that really I
Your sculpting
chose
tools.
To, yeah, yes, right, and but it got so that I was really into my art, and I finally made the decision: it's now or never to get into art full time. So I got out of the hair and got into the art.
How long has that been since you made that choice?
About 10 years ago.
Okay, so that coincides pretty much with when you started working with the Arts Council, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so Shirley brings these usually very large canvases with very bright colors on them, and we find wonderful places to put them, and we have several around in the community in a variety of places. But you've had your work in our program for a long time.
Yes.
And sold a fair amount of work.
Yes.
Through the program. You also do, though, other things. Like, we don't generally show sculpture just because most of our arts placement sites don't always lend themselves to having a piece of sculpture, but you are also a sculptor.
Yes.
And you do clay sculpture?
Clay sculpture.
Tell me about your clay sculpture.
I got into it about 4 or 5 years ago. I decided I wanted to just try it. And I found that I really liked it because, again, it was a way of doing something and letting my mind just go and do whatever that's coming through. It's like my painting. It comes from here. Uh-huh. They're all original, one of a kind, because I can't do the same piece again.
Right, right.
I don't want to do the same piece again.
Well, and it has a way of just coming out different.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Yeah. And so the sculpture evolved. I have it, I make it, and then I have to have it go to the kiln and have it fired.
Uh-huh.
And then I get that and I paint it rather
it.
Than I mm-hmm. rather than glazing it.
Oh, instead of glazing.
Mm-hmm, I get it out
and
I paint it
okay.
to what I want. And so it's quite different.
How interesting. Now, you also do work, and, you know, this kind of, it's interesting to me that Shirley, as a former hairdresser, sculpting hair, in essence, then became a full-time painter and then had to go back into the sculpture because she just couldn't stand not to be doing something like this. So it all adds up in my head. But also, part of the hairdressing thing is satisfying the client.
Definitely.
You know, so the client comes in and they've got something they want done with their hair. Mm-hmm. As a hairdresser, you have to try to meet that expectation.
Right.
And you do that with your painting as well. You do commission work, mm-hmm. which is kind of the same thing,
mm-hmm.
where you take someone's ideas of what they expect or want, and then you give it the Shirley twist. But it's still, mm-hmm. I noticed when we were looking at your paintings that the pieces you do on commission don't always look a lot like your usual paintings.
Right, they don't. Because that is, in that case, I usually have to have either I meet the person or they give mm-hmm. me pictures mm-hmm. to go by, a bunch of pictures.
Right.
And I pick out the one. I have to tell them. I said, I have to pick out one that I feel good about.
Right.
And I feel it will flow with me.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell them that I have to do it my way. I can't do it Aunt So-and-so's way or your way. I have to do it my way.
Mm-hmm.
So what I do is I take usually half down, and when they see it, if they don't like it, then they don't have to take it. They don't have to pay anymore. I keep it.
Okay.
So that way it's fair for them and fair for me.
That makes sense, yes.
And so most people agree that if I let me do it, mm-hmm. let me do my thing and not be told, oh, her nose needs to be this way. They are.
So in a commission piece, you're not replicating a photograph per se. You're taking the photograph and that's your inspiration.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then you're building a painting, an interpretation of that photograph.
Exactly.
Is that right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, a lot of times I merge two pictures into one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which I did with mm-hmm. one painting with the horse and the young lady.
And you were telling me interesting stories, too, about how that you're basically interpreting that person's personality or mm-hmm. what they loved or what they do or something about that person comes across in
mm-hmm.
that commission piece
mm-hmm.
that's different from what, you know, a picture's just a picture.
Right.
You know, not knocking photography. I love photography. Mm-hmm. But, you know, but that's a different
mm-hmm.
approach. In your approach, you're interpreting.
I am interpreting.
So the impressionistic thing still falls through.
It still comes through. And for me, doing a face or a portrait of it, I find that the mouth is the thing that really is the most challenging part of doing the portrait. Eyes,
eyes.
I can do eyes. I love to work with eyes because they say a lot.
Uh-huh.
But the mouth is really the telling piece of the art, of the painting, that really captures that person.
There's got to be something psychological about that whole thing.
Yeah, I wonder. Could be. Could be.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
So how many years have you been painting? Let's put it like this. Have you been painting most of your life?
Most of my life. I remember, as a little girl, I loved coloring books. And I love to draw, and
uh-huh.
At that time, I would draw houses with picket fences.
Okay.
And the reason I did that was a house with a picket fence had to be a happy home.
Gotcha.
For mm-hmm. some reason. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. then it started in high school, I would sit and draw faces of my classmates.
So it wasn't random faces, it was people that you knew.
Yes,
uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. And then I got into doing oils.
Ah.
Which I enjoy doing oils, and I did a couple portraits with oils, but I found I'm better with acrylics.
Yeah.
Because the oil doesn't dry fast enough for me. I'm a fast painter. And with oils, I would end up going in and messing up because I'd want to do something too quickly.
And it would not be dry enough.
It looked like mud, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I decided acrylics is my medium because I can
great.
Do all things with acrylic.
That's interesting. Now, have you tried watercolor?
I can do watercolor with my acrylics.
Okay, yeah. Because, mm-hmm. you know, I was talking to some other artists mm-hmm. recently about how different watercolor and acrylics are, mm-hmm. or oils and acrylics mm-hmm. together. With watercolor, your white is the paper. Mm-hmm. And you have to remember to leave that white mm-hmm. so you can go, you know, use that white.
Right.
Whereas in acrylics and oil, you add the white.
Right.
You know,
right.
so it's a whole different mindset. Mm-hmm. It's a whole different way of thinking. Mm-hmm. So I often am fascinated to talk to artists who can do both because that basically means they're reversing their thinking process. Mm-hmm. And
oh, yes. And it's a little difficult because mm-hmm. You're so used to doing one thing
yeah.
in one way. But with the acrylics, I can do... Right. Kind of a watercolor look, but most people think mine are oils because I
that's true. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I have learned because I work fast to blend, and which is a very hard thing to do with acrylics if you don't work fast.
So you have an oil approach to mm-hmm. acrylics mm-hmm. in essence.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes.
So and you, like I said at the beginning too, your colors are very strong, very
strong,
bold, very
mm-hmm.
you know vivid coloring, mm-hmm. and. You know, she's talking about how much she likes to do eyes and all of that, but her, except for her commission work, her regular paintings, you're not very worried about making it a realistic, this looks just like that. You know what I mean? You're doing something that kind of gives the impression
exactly.
of that's where the term comes
exactly.
from. And so that just fits your work mm-hmm. very well. Very abstract, very impressionistic.
I love doing a face with no face.
I've noticed that. Lots of crowds of people with no faces.
Right, right. And people say, why? I said, it's there if you look. There is a face there. And I have sold some where a person said, that looks like so-and-so. And I just did, you know, part of a face.
Uh-huh.
And so I've sold them because they saw that person in these paintings
you know, that's
with no faces.
Are. Because if you don't get too graphic with it, then lots of people can interpret it their
exactly.
own way.
Exactly. I had some where some people saw a boy
uh-huh.
and some people saw a girl. I didn't say a thing because I want them to
didn't matter what you thought it was.
Yeah, right. Didn't matter. If they saw a boy, that was a boy.
That's interesting.
I paint from within.
Uh-huh.
I go to the canvas, the blank canvas. I don't draw anything. I just start painting.
Really? Okay.
I took classes, but I had to stop because I had this fear that I was going to soon be doing something like the teacher. Nothing against teachers,
right?
But it began to
look like theirs.
Yeah, and I didn't mm-hmm. want that. I want me there,
mm-hmm.
and so I paint with no rules, no rules.
Interesting.
And if it comes out good for me, then it's fine. Even
that's
if
it
doesn't follow the rules, it's fine.
Now, in our arts placement program, you have work at Christie's, I know, mm-hmm. the hair salon.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know where else you have work placed at the moment?
I'm not really sure at the moment,
I think
but
Charles
I was
may
so...
have some of it. We have some variety of places. Mm-hmm. So they can see your work in our program.
Mm-hmm.
Where else
mm-hmm.
can your work be seen?
Well, right now, I'm using my house as kind of a gallery and a studio.
Mm-hmm.
And if anyone wants to come and see my work, they can give me a call and make an appointment.
That's wonderful.
Call me.
Uh-huh. That's wonderful. Mm-hmm. And if you want a commission piece done, all you got to do is call Shirley.
Mm-hmm.
She'll
mm-hmm.
take care of you.
Yes, I will.
That's great.
I love painting, and now I love sculpting, too. So I'm going back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
Doing both things, whatever inspires me.
We're morning. Blessed to have you in our community.
Well, I've thoroughly enjoyed. I really would like to be in Boone so I could take the opportunity to go to all the events. Mm-hmm. But living in Deep Gap, sometimes you just can't go because it's foggy down there.
It's a travel
foggy
obstacle.
Deep Gap for sure.
Well, come to Boone every chance you get.
I do.
But you know, the Watauga County Arts Council works in all parts of the county, mm-hmm. so we're always happy to have your work all over the place, and we just want to keep spreading it and spreading the good and working with people like you.
Good. So. What surprised me is when you put them in hotels, at first I thought hotels, but I sold more from hotels than
any
place.
That's true. Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
So when you go places, watch out for the artwork that has the black sign that has the Arts Council's logo on it. That's a piece of the Arts Placement Program. And if you look real hard, you just might see the name Shirley Hampton.
Mm-hmm. Just Hampton.
Just Hampton. And we are so grateful to you for coming and sharing some information about
your
art with us. And
this
I
has
hope
been fun.
We continue to work with you for many, many years to come.
I hope so.
Stay in touch with the arts all through the community and stay in touch with the Arts Council.
Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.